remember the first time T-Lo came in. And he was very quiet. He's from Austin. Now, when T-Lo came in, first when he was at the gate, I'm gonna tell you what he had on. He had the plaid polo goose on. He had the plaid polo, I'll never forget it. He had a plaid polo joint on with the cookie. This is 80 something. And you know, back in them days, this shit was like $400 or $500. But he was at the door like this, bald head, you know, just like Tata. The one that Jay-Z got, just that they brothers. T-Lo, you know, had the pointy ears of like, you know what I'm saying? But he got, you know, the eyes, he stared at anybody that was, he felt, you know, that needed to be stared at. He was at the gate, the police was ready for, you know, organizing him to get his paperwork for his cell. Let him know what kind of cell he was going to. And that was it. So he stood at the gate and he looked. You know, he looked at the phones, looked around, you know what I'm saying? You know, and that was a very intense, you know, I seen him from afar. He didn't notice me, but I noticed him. I said to myself, that's a real nigga. Even if the odds is against him, he gonna go out. That's what I said. Even if the odds against him, son gonna go out. But you had these dudes, you know, that didn't know him. You had dudes that they heard of him. And, you know, and you can tell that was a very intense moment that he brought to the gate when he was waiting to come in the cell. And it's like everything got quiet. And they look, because, you know, when you come to the gate, Rikers Island, the first thing people do is scheme. See what you got on. Look in your eyes, see if you're going to be a real one or what. You heard? And he was a skinny dude. Real skinny. You know what I mean? I think he had some Reebok pumps on. That's when the Reebok pumps was out. You know what I'm saying? You know, some, you know, he was fly. Came through. So, you know, came in, dragged his bag, went to his cell. But he didn't unpack his cell. He went to his cell, pulled. And he stood outside the cell. And I think people was like, yo, what up? You know, some people was like, yo, what up? Because sometimes when you recognize real. You want to get too explosive with yourself and your character, but you know, you're wink or you're nod, you heard? You know, that's what I used to do. You know what I mean? If I respect power, you wink and you nod, you heard? You keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? That's what real niggas do. You know what I'm saying? You know, real niggas don't try to test all the time. You know, real niggas know their own position. Some of real niggas don't try for real niggas, man. You know what I'm saying? Especially if they feel like real, you heard? Niggas don't just do that. Niggas don't jump out the window and be like, what's up, man? Fuck yeah. That's sucker shit, you heard? I'm trying to pull at you realer than another nigga when you know it's another real nigga there. You don't do shit like that, you heard? You pay homage, you pay respect. And believe me, respect is basically back due. You know what I'm saying? That's a fact. You know what I'm saying? Pumps back then was $150. That's a fact. In 88, 89, yes, pumps was back. Then was like $150. And $150 was a lot of money for sneakers back then. This is more than Pumas and Adidas. Facts. But, you know, make a long story short, so, you know, I went by, you know, my cell was like two cells down from, you know what I'm saying? Boom. And, you know, I went by, I winked, his jacket was crazy. And the cookie crust, the plaid, he had the plaid polo goose, you heard? And, you know, niggas were scheming like, oh, shit, you know what I'm saying? But for some reason, first time in my life that I witnessed a different type of energy with these so-called real niggas that was in the house with me. They was contemplating, which I felt was a weakness. Like, and then I said, oh, shit, you know, you got these niggas, look, these niggas is contemplating. How the fuck they contemplating? And that shit made me laugh. I said, so you know what? I ain't even gonna lie, I liked it that. That's the type of shit I like. I love that type of energy. Because it was unpredictable. Because these niggas, I never see these real niggas. You know, these niggas rob anything that came in it. But they was contemplating, like, they were scared to even talk amongst each other. you know, about how they gonna handle it, because they was afraid that he might know and he might strike first. So I was like, yeah. So I'm looking, you know, I'm in a cut like this, looking like stupid. Look at these niggas. These niggas look like they scared. These niggas look like they fooled. You heard the way they was acting. And he was just sitting out of cell like this. Look, he was just standing out of cell like this and shit. You heard? Just looking. He was just looking. Like he waited for one of these niggas to try. And these niggas respected that. They showed every sign of unpredictability and contemplation. You know, they said protracted warfare is the worst warfare. You know that? That's when you start contemplating. So, you know, when you, and however, you go into a situation where you have to become bold and you don't, 9 times out of 10, you're going to lose that battle. Because you got to be sure. When you enter a battle, you got to be positively sure, and you got to be positively bold of going at the fool, you heard? When you don't do that, and you seem nervous, and you seem unpredictable, you know, you're in a losing battle already, because you're not sure. And then, therefore, you lack strength, you lack aggressiveness, you lack vision, you lack a lot of stuff, you heard?